The Under the Sea short story based off the first two installments of the Descendants saga revealed many clues about what is to come in the upcoming Descendants 3 movie. Maybe you missed a few clues because you were so mesmerized by the magical scenes and beautiful music. So here are 10 things you might not have noticed while watching Under the Sea. Howdy, virals! I'm Lady Blah Blah, and if you're new to our channel, please remember to subscribe and put the notifications on so you won't miss any of our cool videos. Number 10. Goodbye, Blonde, back to purple. Mal has her rocking purple hair going for the entire first movie. But when we're introduced to her in the sequel, she's trying to live up to the expectations of being on the court and has gorgeous blonde hair. As she starts to suffocate more and more at Auradon, as the pressures continue to hold her back from being who she really is, she flees home to the Isle and reclaims her purple hair. If you pay close attention to her wardrobe during the first two movies, you will notice that she has patches of green throughout her dark purple attire. However, the short story of Under the Sea showed Mal in all dark purple. Symbolically speaking, this could be telling us that we will be seeing a darker side of Mal during this movie, maybe even returning to her all-natural roots of being the girl from the Isle. Number 9. A Journey to the Dark Side. After seeing Under the Sea's short story, it is clear that it was darker than the first two movies. Since this is a prequel to the third movie, it's logical to believe that the movie will follow suit. It's important for Disney to evolve the franchise from the first movie, but also walk the line balancing the family-friendly vibe with the darker theme we are anticipating this movie will bring. Number 8. Is it good to be bad? If Mal's dad does in fact turn out to be Hades, he could be on either the side of good or evil. Since most of the main characters have evil roots running through their bloodstream, but yet turn good when given the right opportunity, it's hard to predict which side he could be on. However, there is a clue during the short story that reveals whose side Hades could actually be on. The blue orb hanging around Dizzy's neck, containing Uma's voice, also resembles the blue orb that Mal references as her father. This blue orb could also be symbolic of Uma's blue dreads. If this turns out to be the case, then Mal could be in bigger trouble than anybody ever dreamed of. Number 7. Uma might jump ship. It's no secret that Disney loves happy endings with all of their stories. Therefore, it's safe to say that there's a good chance that Uma may end up turning good after all. Not to mention the fact that during the Under the Sea special, Mal looked a lot more powerful and magical than Uma did, with her glowing green eyes and her ability to stay under the water without having any pirate roots. Uma might be in for a world of trouble when it comes to enacting her revenge plan. Number 6. A new setting under the sea? At this point, it's well known that the character of Hades has been added to the cast of Descendants 3, meaning that some, if not the majority of the movie, will be taking place in the underworld. We also know that the storyline will be focusing on Uma's revenge, along with discovering who Mal's father is. Fans have been speculating that Mal's father may in fact be Hades himself. While we have plenty of time to stew over that mystery, we also have to wonder if the battle between Uma and Mal will take place in the actual underworld, or simply under the sea. The meaning of under the sea also means below the surface, which could literally be where the gates to the underworld are located. Number 5. A darker soundtrack. Music from the past two movies has been mostly light, fun, and upbeat. There has been catchy song lyrics and bopping choreography. But from what we learned from Under the Sea, we may be in for some darker music for this third installment and soundtrack. There are some creepy voice effects done to Mal's voice during Under the Sea, so we might be able to expect more to fit the darker theme of the movie. Number 4. Exaggerated focus on Mal? Since Mal is one of the main characters, it makes sense for her to be an important part of the plot of the third movie. However, based on the short story, it looks like the upcoming movie will be focusing heavily on the feud between Mal and Uma. And since her father is involved for the first time in the saga, it's safe to say Mal is clearly going to be the main focus of this movie. just as she was in the previous two. We honestly don't mind that at all, but judging by social media reactions, it seems some fans are tired of seeing her storyline evolving and would like to focus this movie on the other characters' evolutions. Number 3. Did Mal get some swimming lessons? We all know that the previous Descendants movie that Mal possesses that super cool power of being able to turn into a flying dragon, similar to that of her mother, Maleficent. But new powers may have come to light in the short story. If you remember from the first Descendants movie from her first date with Ben, Mal cannot swim in the slightest. Perhaps Disney forgot this tiny detail, as she was kept underwater for most of the short story? Fact is, Mal was capable of staying underwater for a long period of time with these freakish glowing green eyes of hers, which led us to believe that Mal might be hiding some new cool powers for us all to see in the upcoming movie. Number 2. Rotten to the Core, Part 2. There are several hints that Mal has turned into someone that is definitely rotten to the core. We all know that she's part villain, seeing as she is the daughter of Maleficent, but she proved herself to be more than that during the first two movies. But during the short story, there were several things wrong with the way she was acting, such as walking through the woods alone at night, having freakish glowing green eyes, staying underwater for a long period of time, and having a voice that almost makes her sound possessed. Is Disney trying to imply that she's possessed by her potential father from the underworld? Number 1. Dizzy making us dizzier. Dizzy played a minor role in the second film, being the daughter of Drizella and friends of Mal and Evie. At the end of the second movie, Auradon Prep sent for Dizzy to be collected and come taking part in the school. If this happened, then why is she still on the aisle? How did she know where to find Mal in the dark? And why was she out in the dark in the first place? Perhaps the most important question of them all, why on earth is Dizzy wearing Uma's necklace that belonged to the Sea Witch herself? We are then made to wonder if Uma is really Dizzy in disguise to trick Mal. If Uma is using the necklace in the same way her mother did, trapping her voice inside it, or if Dizzy is actually Uma's partner in crime. It's crazy to think that Uma would ever part ways with that necklace, but if she did, it must be a strong partnership indeed. Dizzy is also a lot older in the second story than she was in the second film. Not that much time has passed that she would have aged that fast. Strange magic is at work indeed, or maybe just some lazy work from the continuity and makeup department. There are so many different fan theories spreading on the internet as to what is actually going down in the third film. From who Mal's father will turn out to be, to who will win the epic showdown between her and Uma. What are your theories? Let us know in the comments below. I'm Lady Blah Blah. As always, thanks for watching, and don't forget to put a like, subscribe, and share this video with family and friends.